Exponents, taking numbers to higher powers. We can look at numbers as wholes and parts. We can add or multiply parts to find out a whole amount. 4 rows of 3 golf balls gives us 12 golf balls. Riding 25 miles an hour for 3 hours will get us 75 miles down the road. It's a shortcut. Instead of adding 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 and counting, we remember 3 times 4 is 12. We calculate 25 times 3, lots faster than counting. Notice the 3 and the 25 repeat. There's going to be a pattern here. We also multiply to find area. 2 times 5 is 10 squares. 4 times 6 is 24 squares. What do you notice about these areas? They've got the same number of rows and columns. 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4. We could count them or multiply to find out. 2 times 2, 4. 3 times 3 is 9. 4 times 4 is 16. For this special operation, when we multiply something by exactly the same number, by itself, we have an even shorter shortcut. What do you notice is the same about these expressions? This little raised number, it's called a superscript, is a 2 in all of them. Here's the tricky part. Where's the 2 in these pictures? Where's the operation? There's no plus, no time sign. The 2 stands for the idea of 2 dimensions, a square. We have to figure out how many squares by multiplying 3 times 3, 4 times 4. We read it as 2 to the second power, or 2 squared. If you say 3, 2, you're missing the action. Practice saying 3 squared, 4 to the second power, to help you understand and remember what it means. Take a minute and complete this table. Let's add a picture and some numbers here. This is what it should look like. So, shortcuts. Always the shortcuts. Powers are a way of talking about an amount. The further you go in math, the more you'll see a few symbols that mean something way more complicated. It is worth taking the time to figure out what they mean. You can do this. What's next? Well, if 4 squared is 4 times 4, what would 4 to the third power be? That's the next video.